This week, government explained the status of missing persons, responding to the concerns raised by the leader of opposition in parliament, Mathias Mpuuga, over human rights abuses. Mpuuga requested the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, for ample time to scrutinize the government's response alongside his team. Speaking to journalists today in Kampala during the National Symposium on Rule of Law, Human Rights and Policing in Uganda, the Butambala County Member of Parliament, Muhammad Mwanga Chivumbi, said, as opposition legislators, they will be giving their way forward on the boycott next week on Tuesday before the floor of Parliament. He hinted on petitioning the International Criminal Court seeking for its intervention in what they termed as gross human rights abuse in Uganda.
Of things, when you add and subtract the statement of Chibalama and the one of the Deputy Attorney General and the government spokesperson, you now realize that for all intents and purposes, this government murdered and killed Chibalama. The unfortunate thing, if we had to charge them for murder, it could be easily triable in our judicial territory. But as we speak now, that it is a disappearance, which looks like it is being confirmed, the one disappearance of one single person at the hands of any authority is a crime against humanity, triable at the ICC, at the International Court.
The network of public interest lawyers who are implementing a project entitled Promoting Democracy, Human Rights and Good Governance in the Country through Enhanced Accountability by Security Agencies suggested that an independent civilian oversight commission should be put in place to oversee the operations of police.
Also, we are aware the police, with all the circumstances within which it operates, with the military almost taking it over, we are aware that and we insist and we continue to work around reforms. First of all, reforms that lead to its demilitarization, but also reforms that will bring it back to the civilian, which is more or less gravitating it to civilianization, because that's what it's supposed to be. But also we are looking into the possibility of probably pushing for a private member's bill to establish a police services commission. Because these were recommendations from judicial inquiries by law and by presidential directive are supposed to at least be deployed, the recommendations be deployed to guide.
Supposed to serve the community, and the community is not supposed to fear police. So once you have the independent oversight authority or commission, whatever it is, it's going to enhance on the transparency and help police to work. Even the policemen themselves, there are issues they cannot take to their fellow police, because they will not be sorted. So once you have the independent civilian authority to provide oversight over police, now police is going to be able to become more accountable.
Uganda's journey of democratization and building a constitutional state based on the rule of law and human rights has consistently revolved around institutional reforms. Story by Jaylet Namoya for the news.